Kia recently announced that they are partnering with a company called Wallbox to bring bi-directional charging to the Kia EV9 in the first half of 2024. And I want to share with you guys today how excited I am for this partnership, because this is something I've been looking at for a long time. So if you want to find out why I'm excited, then stay tuned.
Are you a new or existing owner of a Hyundai Ioniq 5? Then check out my store, because I got a bunch of cool new stuff to show you.
So obviously you got the OG magnetic eyewear holder, but I've also got a new magnet shaped like the Ioniq 5 wheel. Do you like big 40-ounce water bottles or tiny little cans? Well, I've got both. This one shrinks your cup holder, while this one enlarges it. I've also got some for the rear seat. I've also got a keychain that resembles the charging indicator in the charge port. And if you don't even want to see this charge port indicator when you're charging at night, you can go ahead and cover it up with this little guy. These LEDs flash very bright at night, so you might not want people coming over and looking at them. And when you're done, thanks to these two little nubs, you can go ahead and store it right in your charge port.
I design and 3D print these all myself, and every single sale goes towards the channel and helping me grow it a little bit more. So you can purchase any of these products from the links in the descriptions. If you're international, please use my Etsy store. If you're in the US, you can go to my website, ioniqguy.com. You can also purchase them right here without leaving YouTube from the store on my channel page. And if you have any custom requests, shoot me a message, because I'm always open to trying something new. So I appreciate you checking them out, and I hope you like them.
So yeah, vehicle to home and vehicle to grid are two of the most exciting technologies that come along with EVs that I am just dying to check out. Now, if you don't know what vehicle to grid or vehicle to home are, basically you come home from work, you plug in your EV, you'll charge up, regain your mileage from your daily commute, and then as the sun goes down, all that power that's stored in that big battery can then be fed back into your home or into the power lines outside of your home and provide either backup power in the case of an emergency, or can help you reduce your electric bills, because in the evening, electric rates are typically higher and then they drop throughout the night. So this would allow you to provide your own power to your house and not have to pay the utilities an exorbitant fee for that power. Living here in Connecticut, we do not have time of use rates for our electricity. We have one flat electric rate throughout the entire day, and it is on the high side compared to a lot of the country. You can also receive incentives directly from your utility for providing power back to the grid, because it lessens the demand on their facilities. You guys might have seen one of my previous videos where I show in an emergency situation how you can provide backup power to your home's electrical panel. Now, this is limited to 1800 watts, but with this partnership and this device known as the Quasar 2 from Wallbox, you'll be able to output 11.5 kilowatts back into your home. Now, for most people, that is going to be way more power than they're drawing at any given time. So this thing can provide most of your power to your home every night or in emergency situations, depending on how you want to use it. I love the idea of being able to use power from my car's battery that I probably stored in the car from the sun via my solar panels to power my home at night, and not thinking about all the CO2 being spread by those natural gas fired peaker plants that kick on in the afternoon. Here in Connecticut, we have a nuclear power plant known as Millstone, and that provides a baseline power for our state of about 33%. So a good chunk of our power does come from nuclear energy. So let's talk about what the Wallbox Quasar 2 actually is. It is a bi-directional EV charger. Now, what that means is it can put in 11.5 kilowatts, or about 48 amps of power, into the car's battery pack, but it can also take that power out of the battery pack. So if you were to run, say, my Ioniq 5 with a 77.4 kilowatt hour battery pack at 11.5 kilowatts, it would be able to power that full load for about 7 hours or so. Now, this product was announced way back in January of 2022, and it was the successor to their original Quasar, which could output 7.4 kilowatts, but it utilized the CHAdeMO standard. And there were very few cars here in the United States that actually featured CHAdeMO, the biggest being the Nissan Leaf, but Kia did also sell the Kia Soul EV, which had a separate J1772 plug for charging at level 2 at home, and then for DC fast charging on road trips, you had a CHAdeMO plug. So now the Quasar 2 is gonna feature CCS1 as its charging standard, which, with all the automakers switching to NACS, the North American charging standard, or the Tesla plug, We should probably see that sometime in the near future as well, but you will be able to use adapters in that case, so it's not the end of the world that it ships with CCS1 when it first comes out. Now, details on the Quasar 2 are actually pretty slim. I can't seem to find a lot of information about it, but what's interesting is it's outputting DC power to the car, and it's also taking DC power directly from the battery, bypassing the car's AC inverter, and then going to the Quasar 2 itself, which is converting that into AC power for your home to utilize. So it's kind of bypassing some of the charging losses that your car might experience and taking them on itself. And because of this feature, if your car only charges at like 7 or 8 kilowatts, if you have like a older Kona Electric or Kia Niro EV, this can actually charge it at 11.5 kilowatts via those two DC pins on the car that are used for DC fast charging, like at an Electrify America station. So you can actually kind of future-proof an older EV that doesn't necessarily have a high-powered onboard charger like the Ioniq 5 does, or the EV6 or the GV60 or whatever. And that's all charging overheating issues aside that we already know affect these cars. So assuming at night your car is plugged in, if for whatever reason the power does go out, the Quasar 2 will sense that and it will begin taking power out of the car's battery and sending it to your electrical panel. Now, we don't really know how this is going to tie into your electrical panel. You do need to have an automatic transfer switch that will cut power from the grid from coming into the house in that event, because if you are backfeeding your electrical panel with the car's battery pack, if you don't open that circuit going to the transformers out on the street, you could potentially backfeed those wires and cause a big issue for linemen working in the area trying to restore power. So there will likely be some separate module from the Quasar 2 that will cut power from the grid in this event. But I can't seem to find those details anywhere at this point. So with Kia announcing this partnership and saying that it's coming to fruition next year, that means that this product has been kind of cooking for the last 2 years since it was announced. Now, I don't know if that was just manufacturing issues, if that was certification issues. There's not a lot of information out there. So this is still a decent amount of time away, because they are saying a pretty broad window of the first half of 2024. But if this is coming to the Kia EV9, I can only suspect that it's going to be coming to all other Kia products and eventually Hyundai products, because this is something that everybody is going to want. Tesla is working on something like this. Once Tesla has it and everybody starts to kind of find out about it and how it can help balance our grid system, make our grid way cleaner by charging cars during the day with solar and using that stored solar power to run our homes at night, so you don't need all these coal-fired and natural gas-fired peaker plants that are picking up the slack that nuclear can't handle. All around, it's just a great idea. And if you're powering your house overnight, you're probably not going to be sucking down more than, I don't know, maybe 15, 20 kilowatt hours for a big house. For me, I only use probably 4 or 5 kilowatt hours at night, so it's really not very much. In my case, I would only be really lowering my car's range by about 10 miles overnight, so it's really not a big deal. Kia is also claiming that they can save users over $1,000 a year when people sign up for their utilities demand response programs, which will alleviate some of the demand coming from their plants or other plants that they purchase energy from. So it's really a win-win for the end user. You have an emergency backup, you can provide your home with clean energy all the time, and you can also get paid to do it from the utility. So I don't know, that's just a big win in my eyes. And this could be great for people who are considering installing solar on their homes and battery storage, because I don't know if you've priced out battery storage solutions for your home, but like a Tesla Powerwall is $7,000, $8,000 for a few kilowatt hours of battery storage. Now, with this car in your garage, you've got 77 or 100 kilowatt hours with the EV9 in the big battery pack. That's almost 10 Powerwalls, and you're paying for that battery already. Why would you want a second bank of batteries in your home if you don't need it? You can just use your car. So you can meet all the goals that you want with battery storage for your solar system, but also have it get you from A to B. Now, if you're not somebody who's home during the day and you can't charge the car on solar, you're obviously not gonna get that clean conscience that you're charging the car with solar. But there's certain situations where I think this makes total sense. For me, this would be a great solution because I get home from work at about 2:30. In the summertime, I have another 5 hours of sunlight and solar production that I could use to charge the car. And during the wintertime, it's definitely a lot less, but If I can provide clean solar energy for my car and my home for half the year, that's still a win in my eyes. So anyway, guys, I just wanted to share this bit of information with you. I think it's really cool. This is definitely the future of home battery storage. I think you're gonna start to see a lot fewer of the big battery installs going on at homes as people start to adopt EVs and this lifestyle. Now, let me know down in the comments section, is this something you're interested in? Would you rather have your batteries be mobile, or would you rather have a set of batteries in your home dedicated to just powering the house? I'm curious. If you haven't already seen my video on how to provide backup power to your electrical panel with the V2L adapter, check out that video right here. And as always, thanks for watching, guys. Give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Take care, everybody.